And even one of the locations was similar to where we used to shoot during Nagin.
Okay.
So we're really, really reliving all those moments and the fun we used to have while shooting, the show. Mayank from Milleja Bomtum, I think I used to really relate to him. He, because he has one-liners. I am like that. I'm always coming up with these one-liners that I keep saying. They tell you to break up. They say, "Arey, jam nahi raha hai, to break up karo." That's the worst thing to say to somebody.
So you connected with Adha after so many years of Nagin. What was it like to work with her again?
It was fun. I mean, we were so nostalgic about so many things. And even one of the locations was similar to where we used to shoot during Nagin.
Okay.
So we're really, really reliving all those moments and the fun we used to have while shooting, the show.
Yeah.
And even the song was a story-driven song. So there's a lot of emotions involved in it. So I enjoy story-driven, subjects.
So we saw you and Adha back on screen after so long. Is there a possibility of you making a comeback on Nagin with her at all?
No, I don't know. See, Nagin is something which totally, Ekta ma'am decides. And I think every year, we've seen season after season, there's a new story, there's a new couple. So I doubt that's going to happen. But you never know. anything can happen. Yeah. In the entertainment industry, in TV, nothing is impossible.
Coming to your characters on screen, I want to know which character was the one that you related to the most at any point.
I think Mayank from Milleja Bomtum. I think I used to really relate to him. He because he has one-liners. I am like that. I'm always coming up with these one-liners that I keep saying, and I'm always very upfront, just like Mayank was, and I would always be sarcastic about things. So Mayank is somebody I relate to.
But he was also very serious. Are you that serious in real life?
I'm not at all serious. That's the only aspect I'm not in. I didn't relate to him. But okay. Otherwise, sometimes I am serious. It's just that people don't get to see that side of me. I don't know why they're not making a web series out of it. I mean, I'm serious. They should. They should make a show in which they show our lives, what happened after a few years. Milleja Bomtum again. There's so many TV shows winning people's hearts. And they should give it a serious thought.
Definitely. I agree with you completely. You should start a Twitter trend about this. I'm telling you. It'll go viral.
Okay, done. Get Mayank Nupur Gunjan Samrat back.
The response for the song has been fabulous. You know, you were trending on Twitter and your fans went berserk when they saw both of you back on screen.
Honestly, music videos, you don't expect... because it's such a short thing, we're shooting only for 2 days. The song is 4 or 5 minutes. And then you get so much love, in this small span, which is incredible. And I think that's the power of social media. That's the power people have today with them, in their hands and through their phones and through so many things.
So when you have to go to somebody for relationship advice, who do you go to?
And I think everybody comes to me for relationship advice. I'm in a relationship for the longest time now. But yes, I think, everybody needs it. I think my mom is the best person. My mom always is so positive. And that's exactly how I am.
So what is the worst relationship advice that you feel anybody has given you?
I think worst advice, I mean, usually people say, they tell you to break up. They say, "Arey, jam nahi raha hai, to break up karo." That's the worst thing to say to somebody, because one problem for that person is very, it's very small in terms of its magnitude. But the life that you've probably lived for such a long time is far more, better than that one small problem that you're making such a big issue about. So I think everything is solvable. You just need to talk it out, and that's the best thing you can do. You need to talk it out, and of course you need to love somebody for you to even want it to be solved in the first place. If there's no love, you can't solve it anyways because you're going to behave differently.
We want to know how you manage to stay fit. What is the first healthy thing that you do in the morning as soon as you wake up?
Start your day with warm water, 3 glasses, and you know your metabolism kickstarts. So that's the way I do it. After that, I mostly go for a jog, just like for 20 minutes or something. And then I come back, have my breakfast after 1.5 to 2 hours, then I go for my workout. So it's good to run, you know, empty stomach. Just get your, you know, blood pumping, and it's nice in the morning. And yes, you eat healthy. Yeah. I think everything is to do with what you eat. You look like what you eat, and you just got to eat right.
So what does your cheat meal comprise of when you need to cheat?
I can have a samosa also if I feel like, you know, sometimes I do. And I have like carbs, you know, things that I like probably a pastry or say, you know, a scoop of ice cream or something of that sort. But food usually more or less remains the same.
What is your favorite workout to do in the gym?
I like functional. I think it gets you really, really, you know, pumping, like really, your heart is pumping like really fast, and kind of makes you lose fat faster. So I like functional, but I love my weights also. Yeah, but I don't do very heavy weights. I just do, decent weights. Too heavy is then your body kind of becomes very stiff. So I do light weights, and yes, I love functional.